There was such a huge breakthrough for her. And since then, she's had an impressive string of results over the past few months, and she just is building momentum.
And she's going to need it here because Saori Yoshida is an amazing wrestler. Pound for pound, I feel she's one of the best wrestlers in Canadian wrestler and world wrestling for women.
Well, no doubt that Saori Yoshida was the gold medal favorite heading into this weight division. She's the reigning world champion, two-time world champion.
Here we see Yoshida in on a single leg position. The idea in wrestling is to try to pin your opponent. The closer you come to pinning them, the more points you get.
Wrestling match consists of 2 3-minute periods.
What Yoshida's trying to do now is get what's called a takedown, and that's getting your opponent down to their hands and knees or their stomach, which is what happened there. That's 1 point is awarded for that kind of move.
Well, Tanya and her coaches have a strategy that they think will deal largely with Yoshida and her dominance.
Well, it's sort of a two-part strategy. Yoshida likes to attack from the outside, so they're going to kind of crowd Yoshida a little bit. But as well, Tanya is very strong in the parterre position. That's when they're down on the mat. And if you're being too passive, if you're not being aggressive enough, you can get penalized and get put in that position. And that's what Tanya's going to try to do. Be the aggressor and hope that Yoshida gets put in that position.
Now, speaking to Tanya after her semifinal match, she said she has to be careful of Yoshida's leg attacks.
Well, Yoshida's got one of the best leg attacks in the world. She's so fast, she's so strong, and her technique is flawless.
The referee here?
Here the referee is telling the wrestlers not to be slapping each other so much. A lot of times you'll see the wrestlers hitting each other's head, partially for distraction, partially to move them off balance. And all the referee was telling him there was keep that down a bit.
1-0, Saori Yoshida of Japan leading Canada's Tanya Verbeek about a minute and a half into this match.
We see Verbeek not wanting Yoshida to beat her on the outside. She's crowding her, she's trying to hold her in control.
Been a very disappointing couple of days for the Canadian women's wrestling team. Christine Nordhagen, Viola Yannick, Lindsay Bilal all failed to advance to the medal round, all considered medal contenders. But here the underdog pulls through. She's assured at least of a silver medal, but as she... Oh.
Well, another takedown out of bounds there. Verbeek is not showing the same kind of confidence that she showed in her previous couple matches. Here she gets put down in the down position because the point was scored out of bounds, so Yoshida didn't get a chance to turn her. So when they come back to the center of the mat, Verbeek gets put in the down position so that Yoshida gets a chance to turn her. Yoshida's trying to do what's called the gut wrench. If she can expose Verbeek's shoulders to the mat, she'd get 2 points because she's getting closer to pinning her opponent. But if they don't advance the move, the referee stops the match, stands them both on their feet, and starts again in the neutral position.
2-0, Saori Yoshida of Japan leading. Less than 30 seconds left in this first period of this gold medal match.
Well, if Verbeek can, I was gonna say if she can keep the pressure on, but she had to do a little bit of countering there.
There's one of those famous leg attacks by Saori Yoshida.
Well, she's so quick and her technique is so perfect that it's very, very difficult to stop unless you hold her off and control that arm like Tanya's trying to do.
2 points down, though.
Well, 2 points isn't insurmountable because when you get put in the down position and Tanya's very good on the top position, you score 2 points very quickly because that's you're exposing your opponents back to the mat.
Well, her coach is Marty Calder, the coach of Brock University wrestling team, and he's in her corner now. A big reason why Tanya's here. What is he telling her now at this point? Down 2-0, not insurmountable, with 3 minutes left in regulation.
He's telling her, keep what you're doing, be a little bit more aggressive so that she can try to get that passivity call on Yoshida. He's also telling her not to worry, you know. Like we said, 2 points isn't a lot to come back from. She's doing well. She has to get that confidence in her attack, though, confidence to keep pushing her.
Saori Yoshida, wrestling's in her blood. Her father was a national wrestling champion, and she started wrestling when she was just 3 years old. Most women start when they're in their early teens.
Here she is again on that leg attack.
Another point. 3-0 now. She's got to watch. She doesn't want to be turned.
Well, and you see the quickness and the power in Yoshida, how deep she gets in on that shot. The perfect technique she's got. She's always in a great position. And like I said, the only way to stop it is to prevent her from shooting in the first place. Here again, she's trying for that gut wrench. The referee stops it because she hadn't advanced the position. Verbeek's going to have to pick it up here if she has a chance to win. She's going to have to be more aggressive. She's going to have to try some attacks. She hasn't really attacked much at all this match so far.
Yoshida's so quick, though. There she tried.
Well, in a lot of cases, the best defense is a good offense. And so if Tanya Verbeek can be a little bit more offensive, she'll give Yoshida less chances to shoot. Just like that, she's in a good scramble. She was in a good position.
Well, they'll bring them back to the center in the standing position. Just a couple of minutes left, still 3-0. The reigning world champion, Saori Yoshida, leading.
If Verbeek continues to make those attacks, Yoshida will get called for passivity because she's not being aggressive enough, and that'll give Tanya a chance to try to turn Yoshida on the ground.
Oh.
But there's that leg attack again.
4-0 now.
Her strategy was to really prevent that by controlling that arm, but she hasn't been able to do that so far in this match.
Well, Tanya was saying, you know, the Olympics are more of a mental than physical battle, and she certainly won that battle up until this match, but still looking good. We have to remember who her opponent is, the reigning world champion, two-time world champion.
Well, she's a fantastic wrestler, but if Tanya had wrestled with the confidence that she wrestled with yesterday, I honestly believe she could win this match. But it's just a real tough call to come in here with that kind of confidence in such a pressure situation against an opponent like Yoshida.
Looks like Yoshida got hit in the eye. Took a few seconds out there. Now back at it.
Tanya's got to get that leg back, get away from the side there.
Less than a minute left.
The referee's going to look to see if the wrestler is advancing that position. If they're not advancing the position, eventually they'll stop it. That's what Tanya's trying to do there.
Hardy called her in the corner, yelling in frustration to stop. Get back wrestling.
Well, now Verbeek's going to have to open up here. So Yoshida scores as they go out of bounds. And unfortunately, that's almost the nail in the coffin because that's going to put Tanya Verbeek down on her on the down position. They'll give Yoshida a chance to turn her. The clock will count down quite a few seconds.
Well, Chris, with just 30 seconds left, she pretty much now has to pin her. A pin would end the match.
It would, but it's a pretty tall order in a situation like this.
Yoshida trying to turn her.
Well, and what Yoshida's trying to do now is she's trying to make it look like she's trying something.
Okay.
Pretty good acting down there. All she wanted to do was kill as much time as she could.
10 seconds left now. Another point for Saori Yoshida of Japan, 6-0, 6 seconds left, and now Tanya Verbeek in the parterre position.
Well, on those last 2 points, I mean, you can't really fault Tanya. She had to open up, she had to take some chances.
Saori Yoshida wins the gold medal. Tanya Verbeek of Canada wins this country's very first Olympic medal, though, in women's wrestling, a silver medal.